Hi, my name is Norbert Funky and I'm a senior Timestream specialist solutions architect. Amazon Timestream is our offering to work with time series data. And in today's demo, I will show you of how you can create instances with Amazon Timestream for InfluxDB, as well as how you'll use it. So please enjoy. So in my first demo, I want to show you of how you can use the Amazon Timestream console to create a database. As you can see here on the left-hand side, both Live Analytics and InfluxDB here is available. I'm going to doing the InfluxDB database and hit the button Create Database. The first thing I need to do is give it an instance name. I'm using just here EMEA-OTD. Also, it needs to have an initial username. That'll be the administrative user. It's being used belonging to an organization. Then additionally, the data is being stored in buckets, so I need to provide an initial bucket name, bucket telemetry in this case, and then certainly username with password and confirm the password right there. Then I can afterwards select what instance configuration want to use. As Dean showed before, there are different sizes available. Also, I can specify of how much of IOPS I wanted to have. I just leave the storage at 400 gigabytes. It goes up to 16 terabytes. Also, I do a multi-AZ standby deployment in here so that I can log in later. I also need to specify that I have public access to the instance ID. So that'll be gives then the idea there. Also, if you want to use additional InfluxDB parameter, you can create parameter groups. I just leave it as is here for now. Hit the button Create InfluxDB, and that will initiate the creating the instance itself. As you can see, so it is successfully created. This takes usually sometimes, so depending on how much resources you wanted to provision, it can take between 10 and 15 minutes or so. So just wait for here. I already previously created another instance, so that leads me into the second demo of how to log into here. So I'm selecting the instance that is already available. Go to the instance identifier. I can use the button up here to directly go to the UI of InfluxDB. One thing I will do is using the same username and password that I used before for creating the instance itself. I'm signing in. First, I want to check out, has the bucket being created? As you can see here, the bucket telemetry is there. There's just no data yet in there. So from that perspective, let's take a look at how easy it is to actually get data into InfluxDB. You can do it programmatically with Python. So the nice thing is that all the steps are being listed here directly on the UI itself. And you can copy and paste a lot of the code that is available here in there to get started at least. The second thing I want to do is actually use the line protocol that Dean mentioned before. So I have provided some data in line protocol format. Let me just create a new bucket for the sensor data. That's it's basically weather data that I'm loading in there. The resolution in my file is milliseconds, so I have to switch it from nanoseconds to milliseconds. It really depends on how you created the data in the first place. Let me now drag and drop the file in here itself. You can see it's being dropped. By hitting the button Write Data, that allows now to loading the data. It's about 100,000 records that's being loaded, so it just takes a few seconds. And now the data is being loaded. So let's now use the Data Explorer to take a look at how the data is here. And the Data Explorer allows you to create queries. So for example, here I'm using the measurement just to take a look at how the line protocol looked like. So this is the file that I originally loaded some extract. This is, so I have the measurement DS118 in there, a few tags, as well as one field with a timestamp. So now I'm creating my query in the Explorer and wanted to look into the temperature for a particular city, Jersey City, in here in the US. Since the data is a little bit older, let me just adjust also the time window from the last 30 days so that we can be sure that the data is actually there. And you see a little graph on the right-hand side. So let me just expand it a little bit. So now you can see a little bit closer in here, and you see the temperature information, which is in Fahrenheit because it's US based. You can also switch to the query editor. So this is the query, the flux query that has been created by the Data Explorer, but you can also write your own. So I want to do a quick example of pasting in a query that does a simple count aggregation. Now I'm submitting it here. I can switch over to look at the data itself, and you can see for the various channels that are in this file in there, there are many, many thousands of records in here. So this is just the first demo to show you of how you can go from initially creating a database instances and immediately loading data into there that you have available and start working with InfluxDB. If you want to learn more about Amazon Timestream for InfluxDB, here are additional resources that you can use. And also, if you have an existing time series use case, feel free to get us in touch. Either go to the go-to-market team, which is the first email address there, or you can also get directly in contact with some of our specialists with the other link. Thank you again for joining today's video, and feel free to reach out to us for any questions that you have.